Good morning, students. In today's class, we will see another example of frequency independent antenna, namely the helical antennas. We have seen that there are three major categories of frequency independent antennas, which are spiral antenna, helical antenna, and log periodic antenna. We have already covered the topic log periodic antenna. We'll proceed on with helical antenna in this class. Helical antennas. So they are another basic type of radiator, and it is the simplest antenna to provide a circularly polarized wave. It is a broadband VHF and UHF antenna. So this is a diagrammatic representation of a helical antenna. So from the diagram we can see that it is containing of a thick copper wire which is wound in the shape of a screw thread. It is fed between one end of the helix and the ground plane, as shown in the figure. The ground plane is simply a sheet or a screen of a radial concentric conductor. The helix is fed by a coaxial cable, which is having an inner conductor and the outer conductor. The inner conductor is connected to the helix and the outer conductor is connected to the ground plane. The parameter on which the mode of the radiation depends on the diameter of the helix, capital D, and the turn spacing represented by capital S, which is the center to center spacing between the turns. So other than this parameter D and S, we also have small L, which is the distance between the coaxial, the ground plane, and the actual helix. And we have the diameter of the helix represented by capital D. And we have the thickness of the screw helix thread, which is represented by small d. The second diagram gives the radiation pattern of the helical antenna, where we can see that it is having a unidirectional pattern. If we expand a single loop of helix, it forms a triangle as shown in the third diagram. The dimension of the helix are the circumference represented by C, given by the formula pi into capital D, where capital D is the diameter of the helix. Alpha is the pitch angle, given by tan inverse of S by pi D, which is obtained from the third diagram. Small d is the diameter of the helix conductor. Capital A is the helix axial length, given by the formula n into S, where n is the number of turns, l is the length of the turn, and small l is the spacing of the helix from the ground plane. If one of the turn of the helix is unrolled on a plane surface, the circumference pi d, the spacing S, and the turn length L, and the pitch angle alpha are related by a triangle, given by the third diagram. The pitch angle is the angle between a line tangent to the helix wire and the plane normal to the helix axis. Pitch angle is an important parameter of the helical antenna, and it is calculated from the triangle as tan alpha is equal to S by pi d, from which we get alpha is equal to tan inverse of S by pi d. The properties of the helical antenna can be described in terms of these geometric parameters. The different radiation characteristics of a helical antenna is obtained by changing all these parameters with respect to the wavelength. So the L is given by the formula square root of S square plus C square. Substituting for C, we get the formula as square root of S square plus pi d the whole square. So next is the modes of helical antenna. Helical antennas can radiate in two modes. Number one, the normal or the perpendicular mode of radiation. Number two, the axial or the end fire or beam mode of radiation. Moving on to the first type of radiation, which is the normal or the perpendicular mode of radiation. in this category, the radiation field is maximum in the broad way, that is in the direction perpendicular to the helix axis. It is circularly polarized or nearly circularly polarized. This mode of operation is obtained when the dimension of the helix is very small compared to the wavelength, that is when n into l is very much less when compared to lambda. This mode of operation will have a narrow bandwidth and the radiation efficiency also is low. So this mode of operation is not practically used for any applications. We only use the second mode of operation, which is the axial or the end fire or the beam mode of radiation. The radiation pattern of a helical antenna is considered as a combination of equivalent radiation from a short dipole positioned on the same helical axis and a small loop which is also coaxial with the helix axis. So why we are considering it as a combination of short dipole and loop means, we have the pitch angle alpha. When the pitch angle alpha is going to be 0, then it corresponds to a circular loop given by the second diagram. So first diagram is the three-dimensional spherical coordinate helical antenna, where the diameter of the helical is represented by capital D. So once we consider this as a helical antenna, when the pitch alpha is going to be 0, it becomes a circular loop. And if alpha is going to be 90 degree, when the pitch angle alpha is 90 degree, it becomes a linear antenna, which is a short dipole antenna. So by the combination of the fields of a circular loop and a small circular loop and a small short dipole antenna, we can get the overall radiation pattern or the characteristics of a helical antenna. So in a helix of fixed diameter, if S tends to 0, helix collapses to a loop. And if S is constant and if D tends to 0, the helix will straighten up and it forms a linear conductor, which is a short dipole, as given in the third diagram. The helix antenna may be considered as having a number of small loops and short dipoles connected in series, in which the diameter of the loop is same as the helix diameter and the spacing of the helix is similar to the dipole length. Under this assumption, the far field small loop is given by E phi is equal to 120 pi squared I sin theta by R into A by lambda square, where I is the retarded current, R is the distance at which we are measuring the field, capital A is the area of the loop given by the formula pi D squared by 4. If we consider a short dipole instead of a small loop, we already know the equation of a short dipole. It has the electric field in the theta direction, where E theta is given by J 60 pi I sin theta by R S by lambda, where S is equal to L is equal to length of the dipole. By finding the ratio of these two electric fields, E theta by E R, we can get a ratio called as axial ratio. So this axial ratio is represented by AR, which is magnitude of E theta by magnitude of E phi. Substituting the expression for E phi E theta and substituting the area A as pi D squared by 4, we get the expression for the axial ratio as AR is equal to 2 S lambda by pi squared D squared. So AR is 0, elliptical polarization becomes horizontal polarization. When the axial ratio AR is infinity, the elliptical polarization becomes a linear vertical polarization. And when the AR is equal to unity, then the elliptical polarization becomes circular polarization. So the polarization depends on the values of the axial ratio, which is AR given by 2 S lambda by pi square D square. For a circular polarization, the parameter AR is unity. That means magnitude of E theta is equal to magnitude of E phi, from which we can get the expression for the spacing S as C square by 2 lambda. And the pitch angle alpha can be represented in terms of D and C as alpha is equal to tan inverse of pi D by 2 lambda, or alpha is equal to tan inverse of C by 2 lambda, where the circumference C is equal to pi into D. The condition for the circular polarization is alpha is equal to tan inverse of c by 2 lambda. So this is the normal mode of radiation for getting a circular polarization. Moving on to the second mode of operation, that is the axial mode. So in axial mode of radiation, the radiation field is maximum in the end fire direction, that is along the helical axis. The polarization again can be either circular or nearly circular. So in this mode of operation, we have the circumference d and the spacing s to be in the order of the wavelength. So this mode of operation is used in many applications compared to the previous mode of operation. So the typical dimensions of the arrangements, we can see that the length of the antenna is going to be 0.8 lambda. The small l, that is the distance from the ground plane to the helical antenna, is going to be lambda by 8. The spacing s is lambda by 4. The typical value of the diameter of the helix is lambda by 3. The terminal impedance of the helical antenna is given by the formula R is equal to 140 C by lambda ohms. The half power beamwidth of a helical antenna is given by the formula 52 by C square root of lambda cube by n into S, where lambda is the free space wavelength, C is the circumference, n is the number of turns, and S is the spacings. The beamwidth between first null, that is BWFN, of a helical antenna is given by the formula 115 by C square root of lambda cube by n into S degrees. The maximum directive gain or the directivity in the axial mode of a helical antenna is given by the formula D is equal to 15 ns C square by lambda cube. The normalized far field pattern of a helical antenna is given by the formula E is equal to sin pi by 2 n cos theta sin n pi by 2 by sin pi by 2, where psi is equal to 2 pi s by lambda 1 minus cos theta plus 1 by 2 n. The typical value of the pitch angle alpha ranges between 12 degrees to 15 degrees, and n is greater than 3, and the product n into s is less than 10. C is 3 by 4 lambda to 4 by 3 lambda. So we can also have another category of helical antenna, which is the tapered helix, where the included angle alpha, the pitch angle alpha, is either going to increase or decrease. In the first case, the size of the turning also gets increased if alpha is increasing. Again, if alpha has to be decreased, the size of the turnings of the helical antenna has to decrease. So this is another category of helical antenna which is available, called as tapered helical antenna or tapered helix antenna. Thank you.